Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today is part 6 of our VBA series, and we are going to learn how to import a file, showing the file dialog box and letting the end user pick the file that they would like to import. So to start, we have a blank spreadsheet, but soon we are going to fill this with data from an external text file. Because this is a blank spreadsheet, we don't have any macros in it yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Alt F11 to go into the Visual Basic for Applications window so that I can just begin typing a macro. So to start this, I'm just going to type sub import file, and then I'm going to press enter, and you will see that the parentheses have been added as well as the end sub, which means I can start writing my subroutine in between these two lines. So I'm going to need a few variables for this import. The first one I'm going to need is a variable to keep the name of the file that I wish to import. So I'm going to type dim str file as string. If you can remember from last week, we needed a variable to keep track of whether or not the end user had picked a file when the file dialog box was shown. So in this case, I'm going to type dim int selected as integer, and that will be the variable that we will use to show whether or not the end user has picked a file. So those are our variables that we will need for this subroutine. If you can remember from last week, we started off using the int selected, and we set it equal to application.filedialog and a left parenthesis. When you look at the options here, last week we used MSO file dialog folder pick because we were trying to select a folder where we wanted to export our files. But this week, we actually want to pick a file to import. So let's pick the first one, the MSO file dialog file picker. And then I'm going to close the parenthesis and type dot show and then hit enter. I can see that show has capitalized, so my syntax here is correct. So next I would like to put in an if statement that if my int selected does not equal zero, then I would like to write some code. So int selected not equaling zero means that the user did not click the cancel button or the red X at the top of the file dialog box in order to not select any files. So any value other than zero means that the user did select a file, so therefore we want to run some code and import that text file as long as a file was selected. So I'm going to hit enter a couple of times, and I'm just going to type end if right away. It's a good habit that if you start with an if, just type the end if really quickly, and then you won't have to worry about it later on. If you start with a select case, do the end select afterwards. If you start with a do, put in the loop right away, so that those types of code that start with a statement and have to end with the statement are already written for you. I'm going to tab and start typing the code that I want to execute in the event that the user has selected a file from the file dialog box. So if the user has selected a file, the first thing I want to do is set the str file equal to the application.filedialog, left parenthesis, MSO file dialog picker, close the parentheses, and hit dot selected. And remember last week we did a left parenthesis, a one, and a right parenthesis? This means that we're going to work with the first file that has been selected by the user. So if I hit enter, you can see again all of my words capitalized, so I know that my syntax is correct. So what would I like to do with this file that the user has selected? If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. I am going to add the imported file to the queries that I already have inside of my Excel spreadsheet. But since this spreadsheet is a brand new one, there are no Excel queries already inside of the spreadsheet. But this is how you would go about creating one in VBA. I'm going to use the with statement. And in this case, I'm going to always be working with ActiveSheet.QueryTables.add because, like I said, I want to add this file that I'm importing to the queries that I already have inside of my spreadsheet. And what I need to add is a connection that is going to go inside of these parentheses. And for now, I'm just going to hit enter, and I'm going to do end with down here so that I don't forget it. So in here, the add function has two arguments that I want to use. The first one is connection, and I am going to type connection equals with a set of double quotes. And first of all, I'm going to type the word text with a semicolon after it. I'm going to close those double quotes and put an ampersand and type in str file because that is the name of the file that I want to import here. And remember, str file is the file that the end user picked. And I'm going to type a comma, and I'm going to type my next argument, which is going to be called destination with an equal sign. And my destination is going to be a range of where I would like to put the imported file. So in this case, I'm just going to do $A$1. And I need to close those parentheses and go back and put my A1 in double quotes. And then when I move off of this line, you can see that all of my words capitalized, so my syntax is correct. Now I'm going to indent here, and I need to name that query def. So I'm going to put .name equals, and in double quotes, I'm going to put the name data import. Close my double quotes, hit enter. And I'm also going to put .fieldNames equals true, because if I open up the file that I'm hoping to import right here, I can see across the top that my field names are already in there. So I want to carry those field names over into my spreadsheet when I import it. So if I go back to Excel, I do see one error up here. Before I put my equal sign, I do have to put a colon equals for each one of my arguments inside of my add function. So I'm going to just backspace and put a colon equals for the connection and also for the destination. Now under here, I'm going to have to do one more property on my query tables, and that is going to be dot refresh, and it's going to be background query colon equals false. And if I hit enter, I can see the capitalization. And if I alt tab back to Excel and I go to view macros and I run my macro and I select my file here, you can see that my data has been imported. And if I go up to view macros, run macro, and if I pick sales 2, you can see that I've now imported a different file. Even though these files are identical, I really did import sales2.txt instead of sales1.txt. So let's alt tab back to VBA. If I look through here, I can see that I created a variable to keep track of the file that the end user picked. And I created a second variable to ensure that the end user did pick a file name and didn't hit cancel when selecting a file name. I'm going to select that in selected variable equal to the number of files picked by the user by using application.filedialog.show. If that is not a 0, which means the end user did pick a file, then I would like to set the str file variable name equal to the name of the file that was selected. And then using my active sheet, I would like to add that file name to the queries inside of Excel, and then I would like to give it the name of data import, and I would like to denote whether or not the field names are in that file, and then I would like to refresh my spreadsheet to show the results of that file. I'm going to type in the end with and the end if, and then I can now run this code to import a file selected by the user. So it is possible to set up a for each loop to loop through all of the files inside of a given file folder. And what we could do is use some of the information we learned last week and how to pick a file folder. And then we could loop through each one of those files inside the file folder and run the same code here and import each one of the files inside of a folder. That's a little more advanced for what I'd like to go over today, but hopefully this just gives you some ideas on the extensiveness of using Visual Basic for applications. So in review today, we learned how to show the file dialog box again, but this time to allow the end user to pick the file that they would like to import. Next week, we'll go over some more VBA code. If there's anything you would like to see automated, please leave us some recommendations in the comments below. Hopefully you learned something new today, and we'll see you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.